Yo, what's good, people? It's Man Like Jamo. They got me on posh ends again, fam. We're at King's Cross, St. Pancras, Lenovo, Motorola. They're doing a soft launch for a couple of their new devices, 2023. Now, it's cold out here. Let's run the intro and get inside and look at some new tech.
Bush. All right, so when I ran up in the place now, I got greeted by the guys at Motorola, and they were just showing us some of the newest phones that they had released recently, namely the G13, G23, G53, and the G73 thing, all under 300 baht apparently. So I'm gonna have to check those out, give them a little review and first impressions later on. But more importantly for me, what I was interested in was their new announcement of the Think phone, fam. Now, in terms of specs, apparently this Think phone is moving like the older Motorola Edge 30 Ultra, fam. 8GB of RAM, 256GB of storage as standard, and a Snapdragon 8 Plus Gen 1, which admittedly is last year's processor, but it's the top of the range processor from last year, so it is no slouch by any means, fam. Furthermore, apparently they got one security chip in there, so all your top secret Bunda picks are gonna be kept secret and safe. Next up, man went over to the Lenovo section, which obviously is where they had all the laptops and accessories and them things there, innit? First thing that slapped me in my face was this dual screen laptop, OLED screens as well, fam. I think it's called the Lenovo Book 9 or something like that. Man will put the actual thing in the description section below. But basically, you can either have it set up in dual screen mode, so you basically have two screens wherever you're going, or you can set up the bottom screen as a virtual keyboard and trackpad thing like a normal, regular laptop. This thing is wavy. I haven't seen nothing like this, fam. If I get one of these to review, I'm gonna be hella gassed, fam. So make sure you stay tuned for that. The technology is fully technology-ing in this thing here, and obviously it comes with its own little keyboard and little stand, which also doubles up as a case and thing like that, innit? Yeah, man, this thing looks wavy, man. Can't wait to get my hands on it again. Okay, now we're on to the reason why I got out of bed this morning, fam. Lenovo are bringing in a new wave of budget gaming laptops. See, everything I reviewed for Lenovo up to this point in terms of gaming has been from the Lenovo Legion gaming range, which is their most premium gaming range of devices. However, they realize that people like me that can't afford them things there still want to game but want a more budget friendly alternative, innit? So that's where this Lenovo Lock thing comes in, fam, with their new laptops and desktops. Apparently they're gonna be phasing out the older IdeaPad gaming stuff, so you know that might be going on sale real soon, so I'm gonna have a look out for those as well. But yeah, these, they're saying RTX 4050s to 4060s, fam, and don't sleep on that 4050 either, because that is supposed to be outperforming last gen's 3060. So that's a pretty good laptop for gaming at 1080p to 2K resolution with decent frames per second. Now, in terms of the ports, you got a little USB 3.2 Gen 2 and 3.5mm on one side. On the other side, you got a little piece of USB-A with a little privacy webcam switch, which you see in quite a lot of Lenovo devices. Then on the back, we got two more USB-As, Ethernet port, HDMI, and a power plug. Not the most fastest port selection that you can get, no Thunderbolt, for example, but I'm definitely not mad at the port selection that you're getting on a budget gaming laptop. All that I need to see now is how the performance is with those new RTX graphics cards. All right, next up after that, they showed us one of their new gaming monitors. Now, immediately upon looking at it, it reminded me of the older Lenovo Legion Y2530 gaming monitor that I reviewed a couple months back, which I think was 1080p, 240Hz refresh rate, up to 280Hz overclocked refresh rate. And it was a pretty much sick gaming monitor with a good build quality and a wicked panel. This thing now, and I can't even remember the model number at the time of recording this voiceover, but this thing is 4K resolution, yeah, with 144Hz. I'm gonna let them specs speak for themselves, fam. 32 inches on this one as well, so a lot bigger than the 27-inch thing that man reviewed a couple months ago. This thing looks wavy, fam. Can't wait to have a little play with it. Next up, they showed me their newest Legion Slim 7 laptop range, innit? Now, apparently, from what the brother explained to me, they're going to be doing things differently. Previously, they had only the Slim 7 in the Lenovo Legion laptop lineup, innit? But now they're going to be doing up Slim 5 and Slim 7. So you're going to have two different grades of Slim gaming laptop in the Legion lineup. They're going to be doing some other stuff that I truly cannot remember. So I might put it in the description section or something like that. But yeah, no, this pretty much looks like a decent gaming laptop. And to be honest, in terms of build quality, it kind of reminded me a lot of the original Lenovo Legion Slim 7 that I just reviewed. So in terms of performance, I'm gonna have to see what's good there, because apparently they're putting 140 watts of TDP in this slim package, fam. So I'm gonna need to see how they're gonna call that, really, in terms of performance. Port selection was pretty much looking similar to what I'd seen on previous generations, except for the 3.5 millimeter headphone jack is now on the left hand side. You got USB-C PD charging, fast charging on the left hand side, as well as you got Thunderbolt 4 too. On the right hand side, it's also good news, because as you can see, they're keeping the full size SD card reader and of course the little privacy webcam switch thingy in it. Furthermore, on the back, they're doing up three more USB-A ports here, all 3.2 Gen 2 and above. HDMI, which I believe is HDMI 2.1, but do not quote me. I'll definitely put it in the description section below. And you got your little power plug there as well, fam. So yeah, no, port selection definitely looking premium, innit? Now, just quickly, I wanted to show you guys this all-in-one PC, because low-key, it caught my attention, even though Man-A-Man is not a all-in-one PC kind of guy myself. My boy is, though, and I think this is definitely something he'd probably upgrade to. We're talking 32-inch 4K display with NVIDIA RTX 4050 up to 4060 graphics inside, fam. So you can do small gaming on this low key, even high key, because that new NVIDIA 4060 range looks dangerous, fam. Now, I can't lie, I don't know the model number or them things there. I'll probably put it on the screen or in the description section, or let you guys fight amongst yourselves to guess what it's called. But yeah, definitely looked wavy. Just wait to show you that real quick, innit? Now, last but definitely not least, man has to talk about this Lenovo Extreme tablet. I can't even remember what the thing was called, but listen, yeah, we're talking 14 inches of tablet. The thing is running Android. Can't remember what processor in there. I think it's a MediaTek thing though, like a MediaTek 9000 or something like that. But do not quote me. I don't know what I'm doing. Anyway, the screen looked wavy, fam. They were talking about 8 speakers in these tablets. And can I just say something, fam? I found recently that the speakers in tablets seem to be a lot better than the speakers in laptops. Why is that? I don't know what's going on. I found that in the Galaxy Tab range. I found it in the Lenovo P12 Pro and P11 tablets that man tested out last year. I don't know what they're doing, but these speakers are definitely doing up loudness and quality, and the whole unit together definitely giving laptop replacement. I just want to see what price it is, because if it's given laptop replacement, I guess it should be kind of laptop priced, but I don't want to pay laptop prices for a tablet. You understand? So yeah, let's see what Lenovo do with this one still. All right, people, and that's a wrap for the Lenovo Motorola launch event, fam. So a couple, two new pieces of tech in there. Bare things I need to get my hands on, so don't worry about me, guys. I'm gonna get begging in the emails, fam. I'm gonna be deep in the DMs with Motorola and Lenovo, asking them to send me down that tech to review. Anyway, Man-A-Man is tired, walking and talking. It ain't me, fam. So I'll catch you guys in the next one, innit? All right.